Working in this kind of emergency situation is not new to me. I have worked in Sri Lanka during the war, immediately after the war. I have worked in Bardha, in Thane cyclone, the recent Chennai floods. I have worked several years in Afghanistan. So, but they're all different situations. It's different because each has its own uniqueness to it. For example, conflict situation, you're always afraid to go out, you hear the bombs, you hear the shelling. With the floods, the cyclone, you know it's out there. Either you're intervening after the cyclone or after the floods. But this is very different because there's a lot of uncertainty, just like all the other situations. But this is unique in the sense that uncertainty, that things keep changing by the day and not knowing what's going to happen next. And to know that the whole world is locked down. So in a way, I think it's very unnerving to see that we are all in the same situation. Anything could happen anytime. So it's very difficult. And I think, like I mentioned earlier, the most difficult part is that people are not able to go out and help the other person. So that, like in Chennai floods, we all came out and we were all there for each other, and that was such a warm experience. But this is not like that. I visited my family yesterday and I couldn't even shake hands with them. And we are a family that hugs each other. And it was very, very difficult, very emotional to know that the distance is growing. And so that's very sad, very difficult. When we are working together in the telecounseling, we have to stay away. We are conscious always about social distancing. We're talking about being washing your hands. So I think this is very challenging, just the way the virus is and how it spreads, and that it keeps us away from each other. However, the nice part is that the environment is getting cleaner. The roads, because I have to commute to get to this place where we are doing the telecounseling, it's so much easier. There's nobody on the street, so there's no traffic at all. So that way there is a small positive side. But I think knowing that we have to keep away from each other, the social distancing part is very difficult. Another aspect, challenges to think, when I think about, is knowing that the social distancing is such a privilege, because people who live in the slums, I work in the refugee camps, there cannot be social distance. There is no possibility, because the houses are all row houses. It's one next to the other. And the people don't have the luxury of isolation. I mean, if one person is positive, they are in the hospital. And if they are a suspect, then there is no way that they can be isolated. They are in a camp or they are in a slum. It's just a 10 by 10, 10 feet by 10 feet room. So I think these are things that the thought process makes it very difficult. The migrant workers is another example of what was difficult in this situation. People having to walk 2,000 kilometers is very, very difficult. So I think these are some of the more difficult, challenging, not much spoken about, but the subtle aspects of this virus and the challenges that we face around it.